r/AskReddit. What product has a better use than its intended function? Reddit for market research. The company I work for recently sent out an email about this. Hey everyone. Do you know about the Reddit? We can now pull information and use it for marketing. The Reddit. Punk rock tried to kill the Reddit but they failed, as they were smited to the ground. My cell phone works better as a way to browse Reddit than it does a phone. In the 90s, it was a common to joke about this phone can make pictures, play MP3, organize your day. But can you actually call someone? I've not heard this for quite a while and I think the reason is, now, it's just true. Actually phoning someone is a minor use case for a phone today. I mean, these devices are marketed as phones, but they're really just computers. Sure, they have an app that lets you call people using cell phone towers, but that's just a small part of it. Bluetooth speakers. I bought one once for its intended purpose of listening to music, but then when I realized how small they actually are, they've pretty much became one of my favorite tools for office pranking and shenanigans. Record a coworker's desk phone ringing, place the speaker behind their phone, and then start playing the ringtone over it. Electronic whoopee cushion. Hide it in an inconspicuous place in an otherwise open area. Then play a whispering voice, hey, name. Look over here as people walk by. Great for people who believe in ghosts. If someone keeps a door closed normally, hide it as close to the door as possible. Then play knocking sounds. Hide it in a cubicle office and just play random, loud sound effects. Someone connected to mine and started blaring Hispanic music through it while I wasn't home. Neighbors got mad. I had to appreciate the ingenuity. I've heard of people doing the same thing with Wi-Fi Bluetooth-enabled printers. As a general rule of principle, I never connect access any piece of technology that I don't own or have permission to use, but it is a pretty hilarious concept. Haha, my landlord lives upstairs and both of our printers are Wi-Fi enabled. One day I had to print some concert tickets and accidentally sent them to the wrong printer. A couple months later he sends me a pic of my tickets with a text that said, "Did you ever make it to your show? Sorry I don't use the printer much. Gave me some fantastic prank ideas." : Viagra was intended to help treat high blood pressure. You can also put some in a vase with some flowers and they will stay upright longer. Tube guitar amps. They were never intended to produce distortion, but a whole genre of music was born by misusing them. Reminds me a little of the Roland TB-303 synth. Originally designed as a little synth to make bass backing tracks for guitarists to jam along to, but instead led to the creation of acid house and many other electronic music genres. What sound great overdriven too. Melamine foam. AKA magic eraser sponges and Mr. Clean magic sponges. Melamine foam was originally used as pipe insulation and soundproofing but was later discovered to clean surfaces like magic. I just introduced friends who were worried about their security deposit to the magic of the magic eraser. It's funny the things we get excited about as grown-ups. I knew I was a fully grown-up when my friend called me all excited that she got new windows for her entire house and I was equally excited. My married friends put a fence into their backyard and I was genuinely impressed and interested in the process and how it turned out. And after that, we chatted in the driveway about benign shit and I was perfectly content. Until the thought hit me that I am currently the age my mom was when I was born. That she had a 4-year-old son at the time. And that if I was that age standing next to her during this visit I would be so bored and impatient and fidgety. Adulthood is weird. We're just bigger baby SS that are slowly exhausting the novelty of the world as our capabilities grow. Pipe cleaners. Meant for cleaning tobacco pipes. More often used in a million craft projects. Just don't use a craft pipe cleaner for actually cleaning a pipe. Lest you end up with little bits of plastic synthetic fiber stuck in your pipe. Be sure to use a real pipe cleaner if cleaning an actual pipe since the fibers tend to be packed wound much tighter so they don't fall out. Oh, I didn't know that. Despite the incredibly obvious name. As a kid I always thought what pipe is small enough that makes this useful. I think it should be said that the craft variety is not to be used for cleaning. Newspapers are really good for cleaning windows. What how? The fibers and ink somehow make things even more streak-free than paper towels. Personally I use coffee filters when I want completely streak-free glass. I've never thought to use coffee filters. Definitely going to try that next time. For best result, use new ones. Originally, gasoline was a byproduct of making kerosene. Dunno if it counts, but byproducts don't usually have an intended use. Heavy water was a byproduct of fertilizer manufacturing. Then suddenly in World War II everyone wanted to get their hands on it. Aluminum foil. People use it to wrap food while they can use it to make rockets, electromagnets and hats that prevent the government from mind controlling you. Royal Dansk Tinsa sewing kits. It seems universal. Every person I've spoken to, every ethnicity, age, culture, they all know about it. Amazing. I'm always so excited when I actually find cookies in them. I will always buy these when I see them. BC, the cookies are delicious and the tins are nostalgic. Red heart. A tennis ball. Entertains animals for days. Works as an amazing massage tool and physical therapy. Protect your floors from chairs that scratch and more. Can throw a couple in a dryer with a comforter and it will actually dry instead of bunching up and staying soggy. Read this comment. Got up to go add tennis balls to my comforter in the dryer. Cheers. Neoprene. Apparently it was originally used as a lining for industrial waste but obviously now makes a good wetsuit and has many other industrial uses. I use neoprene as lining in the purses and bags I make. It gives them a good structure that's still flexible. I use default web browsers to download Firefox Chrome. I feel so bad when I changed the default to Chrome and they said, "Are you sure you don't even want to try it? We made it better just for Windows 10 equals." I was heartbroken. Pedialyte for hangovers. They had a booth at a big music festival I went to last month and were giving out samples. I think their marketing department has caught on. I saw a Pedialyte commercial literally yesterday where they were advertising it as a hangover cure. The marketing has definitely caught on. They're really good for hydrating in general. Also fantastic if you work outside in the desert, Phoenix, Vegas, etc. I always keep fingernail clippers in my purse because I can use them to cut so many things. Little plastic tags on new clothes, zip ties, or even yarn when you want to knit on a plane and they don't let you have scissors. They are insanely powerful for their size. That's the power of leverage. Hitachi wand. Fun story related to this. One of my co-workers is very sweet and although mature and adult, she can be a bit innocent naive with some things. There had been a week or two in work when we were super busy. Everyone was stressed and pretty much everyone had made comments about wanting to get a massage at some point. A Monday morning came, and this girl arrives into the office with a Hitachi wand. I stared wide-eyed at her and then she said, "I brought in my massager. We can all massage our backs now." And had this look of such pride that she had done such a lovely thing for everyone. I didn't have the heart to say anything to her, so I just smiled and said thank you. As more people arrived into the office, she said it to everyone. Eventually one of the guys told her what most people use the wand for. She didn't believe us, so we spent a solid hour sharing articles with her about it. She took it all in good fun and was able to laugh with us about it. We still often tease her whenever she mentions her back being sore. Did she miss work the next day? Nah, she just arrived into work walking like John Wayne. Silly string is used by soldiers to detect tripwires. Actually, there was a pretty good best of post a few years ago by a dude who was in Iraq. He said rumor of this got out and some folks organized a giant shipment of silly string to his unit. Turns out they never really did that, but used the silly string for pranks instead. The army is 90% waiting for shit to happen. Not surprised. In basic training they teach you to never let your guard down. When you get to your actual unit they teach you that your job starts when the first truck in the convoy is blown up. Serious string trademark sign. Water pipes. All over the smoke shop there are signs saying that all the glass products are for tobacco use only. However, I find that they work much better for smoking marijuana over tobacco. Who knew? During Prohibition, bricks of grape juice concentrate would warn the consumer not to leave grape juice in a cupboard for 3 weeks, lest it ferment into wine. Thank goodness they put those warning labels on. I naturally drink several bricks of grape juice a week and wouldn't want any of it to spoil. Just don't say that at a head shop, or they won't sell it to you. It's one of those things where they know you are gonna do it, You know they also do it, and they know you know they know, but you can't say it. Source. Saw a guy say it. He didn't get to do it. Barbie doll's legs. They served as a great scratcher for my itchy leg when I had a cast on it. The arch of her foot was perfect. The balaclava for rubbing instead of a ski mask. I always confuse balaclava with baklava. Someone robbed a bank using baklava? Like WTF. Charmed the teller into giving you cash? Gimme the money or you'll be finding flaky bits of crust around your workstation for the next 3 days. I have noticed the upvote downvote buttons have far more utility as I like this docu buttons than as a rating of how relevant the content is which it was made for. Pennies are far more useful for checking your tire treads and making souvenirs at the zoo than being used as currency. I was a medic in the army. Tampons were part of my regular trauma kit in the field because they were perfect for quickly plugging gunshot wounds. Condoms are awesome. They are used to cover gun barrels, cook meatloaf, waterproof phone covers, ice packs, and everything in between. If you ever need a cheap, waterproof container that can be used for many different things, use a condom. If I may, their intended purpose is so far and above those uses. Those uses saves you minor annoyance, a little time, and a little money. A condom used for its intended purpose saves you 18 plus years of annoyances and possible heartbreak, and untold thousands of dollars. Listerine was used as a surgical antiseptic when it was first invented and now it's a mouthwash. You can also spray it on gross smelling feet to get rid of the odor. Source. I have schooling in massage therapy. Hitachi actively denies that its wands are used for anything other than back massages. Actually, they have sold the rights to Magic Wand to a sex toy company, Magic Wand Original. A whole slew of medications. My daily medication is an anti-seizure medication. Works like shit as an anti-seizure medication, but works fantastically as an antipsychotic. I never once used baby oil on my baby, but I use it to remove eye makeup whenever I wear eye makeup. They call it baby oil because it's made from babies. Mayonnaise. It's amazing for removing stubborn sky residues. Use it a lot in my job. It's also an instrument. No, Patrick. Mayonnaise is not an instrument. You can use your trusty old frying pan as a drying pan. I'm going to say kerosene as it relates to glass coating. Kerosene is a freaking energy dense fuel, which is why we use it to put shit in space. But damn when you dip your glass cutting tool in it before scoring a pane. Freaking magic happens. Honestly, is there a video of this? I'd love to see that. I can't imagine how it would aid cutting glass. I'm hoping someone who knows something about the physics behind this will step in and explain, or show it, better than I can. But here's my experience. If you take a steel glass cutter and run it along a pane of glass, with the right pressure, you'll leave a score, but you won't cut through the glass at all. At best, you can make a cleave point that allows you to, hopefully, crack that glass along the score. But when you add kerosene to the equation, that normally amorphous glass starts to behave like a crystal. You make the score, and the fracture is pretty much transferred through the glass in a nice and clean fashion. You really need to experience it firsthand. AOL CDs as drink coasters. Back in the day, prior to the AOL CDs, they had AOL floppy disks. They had a stack of literally 1,000 at any given time at the post office. No one in my town realized that the disks weren't strictly for installing AOL. So, I would just take handfuls of them, format them down, and I accumulated a few GB of storage via floppy disks. That's a lot of floppies. 1 GB is about 700 floppies. Hair dryers if you need your shirt dry in a hurry. Lay your shirt out on a dry towel. Roll the shirt up in the towel. Work the towel a bit with your feet. Dry shirt appears. TVS are great babysitters. Only if the baby can endure the weight. Probably Everclear. It's supposed to be consumed, but is a fantastic cleaner. Everclear can also be used as an antidote to antifreeze poisoning in dogs, given diluted in an IV bag, not orally. There is a newer product now, but for year we kept a bottle of Everclear in our medicine cabinet at the clinic. Hair conditioner works best as shaving foam than some brands of shaving foam. Bing is much better used for porn. whereas Google is used for everything else. Until they ripped out the other OS option, PS3s were awesome at doing tasks requiring many computers all working on a single project, like drug research. My guess is that Sony took that option out when they were seeing thousands of PS3s purchased, which they'd take a loss on, with no games, where they make the real profit, bought with them. The Daily Mail is excellent for house training puppies. This thread, if for uses other than the intended one, the Daily Mail is designed to have shit between the pages. Apparently, Coca-Cola has some amazing cleaning purposes. Lime stains, water rings, oil stains in the driveway, just Google or YouTube it. Vinegar, not just used to put on your hot chips, bicarbonate of soda, not just used for cooking. Have a blocked sink, if you can. Remove the drain cover, pour in some bicarb and then follow with white vinegar. It fizzes and causes a reaction that helps loosen the blockage. Throw some hot water down the drain. Repeat if necessary. Sudo much cheaper than a plumber. Create a paste of bicarb and water. Use it to scrub stubborn stains off your stovetop. Grab an empty spray bottle. Put a cup of white vinegar and 1 cup of liquid dishwashing detergent. Wet the shower screen. Spray the mix on and let it sit for about 10 minutes. Grab a light scouring pad and starting at the top. Scrub, lightly, the glass. You might need to be a bit heavier on the bottom of the glass. Rinse off and voila. Clean, clean glass. Also good on the oven doors too. Actually, any glass. Slotted spoon. Spaghetti scoops. I bought a really good quality one to use as a back scratcher. Dawn dish soap. That shit gets anything off anything. Also, if you wash your car with it in the water when bugs hit your windshield the first week or so, they just bounce off like Rain-X. My favorite crazy conspiracy theory is Dawn dish soap causes oil spills so they can do animal testing of their soap without anyone complaining. Don't wash your car with dish soap unless you're ready to apply polish and wax. It leaves the paint unprotected. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.